Two questions about New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. Mm-hmm. The first is, I just wanted to know if the White House had any sort of reaction to these twin reports in the Wall Street Journal and the New York Times that aides to Governor Cuomo had altered the report on nursing home deaths to hide a higher death toll.
We've certainly seen those reports. Obviously, they're troubling, and we certainly would support any outside investigation, but those wouldn't be determinations made by us.
Okay, and on the other controversy that Governor Cuomo's facing, the third accuser did a long interview on CBS News last night. I'm wondering if the vice president or the president watched it or heard about it.
I'm not aware of them watching it. They obviously both have a full schedule we keep them to. Of course, as I've noted in here before, but it's I welcome the opportunity to repeat.
Well, so I guess my question is, in 2017, when then-Senator Kamala Harris was calling on Senator Al Franken to resign mm-hmm. for similar issues, she tweeted, and I quote, "Sexual harassment and misconduct should not be allowed by anyone and should not occur anywhere." So, you know, what does it say to women like Charlotte Bennett when the Vice President of the United States will comment about that but won't say the same thing about these allegations against Governor Cuomo?
Well, I think the Vice President's view is that she believes all women should be treated with respect, their voices should be heard, they should tell their story. There's an independent investigation that is happening now being overseen by the New York Attorney General, and she certainly supports that. And hopefully all of the individuals who have come out should see that as her point of view and one that I'm happy to reiterate on her behalf.
But so why won't she say that?
Again, I think I'm speaking on her behalf. This is the White House. That's the benefit of doing this briefing every day.
Are there any discussions within the White House about reversing the policy of allowing all unaccompanied children into the United States?
No.
None at all.
So I guess, is the plan then to take in and safely and humanely find a home for an unlimited number of unaccompanied children?
I think this issue requires us taking a step back as human beings and as mothers, of which I am one. I know there are many in the room or many at home. These kids are coming. They are fleeing prosecution. They are fleeing difficult circumstances in their home country. When they come here, all we're talking about here is ensuring that they are treated safely. They are not trafficked. They are not sent back on a unsafe journey. That's what we're talking about. When they come, when these kids come in, it doesn't mean they are ensured that they get to stay. They go through the processing system that everyone goes through. But we want to ensure that that is done by treating them humanely and with respect. Many of them will be sent back home eventually, but we're talking about how we treat them as they come in the country.
Well, and I'm a mom too, so I certainly feel for all of these children that are fleeing very difficult situations in their homes to come here. But, you know, the fact remains, you have DHS projecting 117,000 unaccompanied minors by May. And, you know, that brings me to another question. You know, a lot of these numbers and this data, they're all coming from leaked documents from DHS, from HHS.
Yeah.
Why doesn't the White House just release these numbers? I mean, don't the American people deserve to get the data straight from you and straight from the White House?
Data of projected numbers and internal documents for policy discussions?
Data about how many unaccompanied children and migrants are crossing the border on a daily basis. I understand eventually it's made public, but why not right now?
It is made public by the Department of Homeland Security and the officials who oversee the entire process. It is made public, but we don't as a policy make public or confirm private decks and policy documents as no administration would.
So can you confirm how many illegal border crossings there are on average every day right now?
I would send you to the Department of Homeland Security and CBP, who of course would be overseeing that process.